AIL travel agent is charging 10,000 rupees for air ticket and 500 rupees is commission. Alright. So you tell me the entire amount 10,500 is not a consideration. Only his 500 is a consideration, because 10,000 he will take from customer and he will get to Air India or, you know, airline. So his commission is his income. That is 500. So he should charge GST only on 500. Okay. Next. Messrs. L Limited, being an authorized dealer of TT brand, rendered services to buyer of car, but payment is made to authorized dealer by TT company. Now what is happening, you know, this bike servicing and all. In bike servicing and car servicing, what happens? This car company, bike company, they say first three services are free. Or first five services are free. Now they are saying it free, but the service center will charge some money, isn't it?
Yes.
Service center will clean your bike, maintain your bike for free. They will not charge anything from bike owner, but they will charge money from
company.
So what is happening? Service is given to bike owner, but consideration is paid by
company.
So third party is making payment. Is it possible that consideration is paid by somebody else?
Yes.
Will it be chargeable?
Yes.
Yes, it is chargeable. Okay. It is called as a consideration given by? Hello, consideration is given by?
Third
person. Therefore, it is treated as a supply and there will be tax on it. Yes or no? You understood this?
Yes.
Yeah. For example, you can write down bike servicing or car servicing. Next. A sport club agrees to hire services of cricket player Mr. C for a consideration of 2 crore. This usually happens in football and cricket, specifically in IPL and all. So I wanted to take one player for 2 crore rupees. Okay. Now what has happened? In addition to this, the agreement provided player shall not provide with a car valued rupees 20 lakh rupees. So how much money ultimately I am going to spend on the player? 2 crore rupees I am giving him in check and 20 lakh rupees car. Yes or no? Alright. So the GST will be levied on?
Entire amount.
2.2 crore. Yes or no?
Yes.
You understood? One is monetary consideration 2 crore and 20 lakh rupees?
None.
By giving you all these examples, your institute wanted to make sure that you should understand the concept. They are giving similar type of examples again and again, but different situations. Because your client may ask any random doubt and one of the doubt may belong here. Alright. So, have patience to read all this. Although it is taking time, but we don't have any other thing to do. You come here to read only, isn't it? Yeah. So, example 21. Mr. X sells office furniture to Y. Office furniture, not home furniture. Office furniture to Y on a condition that donation of 10,000 is payable by Y to a trust. The amount of 10,000 is paid by Y by a reason of purchase of furniture. So he is not paying voluntarily. So what is happening here? A buyer is not giving money to seller. Buyer is donating that 10,000 to some trust. Yes or no? Are you getting this? Similarly, I can also go and tell to deliver, sir, I will teach taxation here, but you have to give 1 lakh rupee donation to my family temple.
Yes.
Is it my consideration? Directly or indirectly, is it my consideration?
Yes.
Yes. Will it be taxable?
Yes.
Answer is yes. It will be considered as a consideration and there will be tax on this 10,000. Messrs. Dev Limited agreed to sell its business to Messrs. RN Limited for a consideration of 50 lakh. Now here business is sold. Have you heard about amalgamation?
Yes.
This is kind of amalgamation. Further agree that it will not conduct the same similar business for a period of 10 years, for which RN Limited paid 20 lakh rupees. Yes or no? Hello? So I am buying your business and I am asking you not to do something. Doing something is also a service. And not doing something is also a service. For not doing same business, you are charging 20 lakh rupees. Yes or no? Taxable or not taxable?
Taxable.
Taxable. So whole 70 lakh rupees will become taxable. This is forbearance of an act. I am restricting myself from doing something. For you, and for that you are paying me 20,000, I am actually providing you service of not doing something. Am I clear? So not doing something is also service, taxable. Mr. A, during a long drive with his wife, Vava, Bela violated traffic rules. Okay, so with wife, no, so many things are happening. And was imposed fine of 1,000 rupees. Now you tell me, breaking signal is not a kind of service and all, right? Is it a supply of service? No, right? So you have broke the law, you are paying 1,000 rupees fine. How bad it would be if that officer is asking, okay, 1,000 plus 18% GST. Why? Because you are providing the services of breaking signal. No, that cannot be the case, no? So penalty is not a consideration for activity. Penalty is a, you know, fine imposed on you for breaking of law. So that is not subject to tax. Yes or no? So somebody may ask you this question, no? Whether this penalty charged by traffic police and all, consideration is there, but it's not their, you know, business. And they are not wishing their traffic hawaldar standing there. Today, 100 people must minimum break signal and then only my business will grow. It's not like that. This is a law that you should not break the signal, but you are breaking it. So we are putting your fine on you. It's not consideration for an activity. Okay? Yeah? So Mr. Aid, so this is what happening. So the amount received as a fine or penalty for a violation of statutory provision will not be considered as consideration. It's not a consideration. Am I clear? Penalty is not a consideration. Remember this, and this is very important. Read this again for your understanding. It's not obvious in nature. Then they are saying, usually, you know, in house you are having parents, and if you are in house you are having parents, and sometime what happens, your mother will say, beta, please go and buy milk. Now milk is available at 35 rupees, but amma has given you 50 rupees. I'm 100% sure you will not give that 15 rupees back to mother. Yes or no? That is your consideration for service. Now you tell me, is it a supply?
No.
Why? Because buying milk from the market is not your business. There is a consideration. 15 rupees is a consideration. But is it your business to go and buy milk?
No.
Sometime your father must be tired and he will come from office and just say, beta, will you put oil on my head, or can you provide some massage to me? You are giving that massage and you are saying, papa, 500 rupees. And papa being like you are a childish, no, you are, although you are grown up, but you are still acting as a childish, so he will give 500 rupees, he doesn't care. So he gave you 500 rupees. Will you say, papa, 18%? Then papa will give you one slap, no? Alright. Why? Because providing massage is not your business. Although there is a consideration, but there is no business element. Yes or no? Alright. So this pocket money or grant money or gift, you know, that's 500 rupees as a gift, is not a consideration for service. The moment I say gift is not a consideration for service, one manipulation comes in my mind. I can come to Dilip sir, and because we are having not only commercial relationship, we are also having friendly relationship. So I can go to him and say, sir, teaching is my passion and these students are amazing students. I love to teach them. So I don't want to charge anything for my services. I'll teach free. But my birthday or New Year or Christmas or Diwali, something is coming, sir. Why don't you gift me 2 lakh rupees jewelry, or, you know, bike or something? Then he said, why don't you take fees? I said, no, fees is chargeable to GST. Gift is not chargeable to GST. Yes or no? Just now I said gift is not chargeable. But gift which is actually gift. Hello, do you understand gift which is actually gift? That means my birthday, and genuinely you brought me one dairy milk. That is gift. It's not taxable. This gift taken from my customer for services, is it a gift?
No.
This is, I'm calling it as a gift, but it is not a gift, because that is which has not been given in terms of reciprocity. Reciprocity means I have done something and in exchange I'm asking the gift. I'm asking gift. Hello? So it's not genuine gift. If it is genuine gift, then only it is not taxable. If it is a consideration for activity, then it will become taxable. Am I clear? So that is, it is clearly written there. Then some people get married, some people are getting divorced. While getting divorced, the wife is asking, I want 50% of your property. What will you do? You are having 100 crore rupees. She is asking 50 crore. Will you give 50 crore?
Yes.
You will give 50 crore plus car plus plus whatever you wanted to give, plus you will hug her and say, get lost. Now already you have given 50 crore rupees. How disastrous it would be if she says, okay, now add 18% GST on it. So government said, okay, this is your personal matter, we don't want to interfere. Alimony paid on divorce is not a, it's not that your wife is providing you service and it's a business of your wife to get married and then get divorced and earn consideration out of it. Although it has become business to some extent in some families, all right. But technically it is not a business. Yes or no? All right. So alimony of a divorce is not taxable. Okay. So this is written in law. You people can start business, no problem. Not taxable, exempt services, what else you want? At least two, three times in a life you can earn this. Okay?
For girls,
no? For girls, who is going to give anything to boys? Nothing. We are not going to get anything. So this business is only for girls. Yeah? Subsidy given by government to benefit farmers. Hey, subsidy given by government.
Not taxable.
Not taxable. It is not a part of consideration. Okay, so it is not taxable. Next, deposit which are returnable in nature, not a consideration, not taxable. Okay. Then equipment and instruments sent to manufacturer factory for repair. This laptop is not working properly, so I took it for repair. Is it a supply?
No.
No. He will repair and he will give it back. No.
Yes.
So this is not supply. Are you getting this? Yeah, so this is not supply.
Is this a service?
No, for him it is service. For repair guy it is service. I'm asking for me. I took my laptop which is not working properly. I kept it in service center. Is it a supply from my side?
No.
No. So will I pay GST on this?
No.
Although there is a movement of goods, but there is no supply.
Ha,
for that repair guy, for him it is service, yes or no?
Yes.
They are not asking for him, they are asking for equipment manufacturing company. Okay, it's not a supply since no sale has taken place. Yes or no? Okay, sale is not there. Only movement of goods is not important. So he is taking, now after lecture he will take this project back to the head office. Yes or no? Is it a supply?
No.
There is a movement of goods, but it's not a supply. Okay. X Limited supplied spare parts freely to replace during the warranty period. Is it a supply?
No.
Hello? Is it a supply?
No.
Free replacement, no?
No.
Are you getting free replacement? Free replace. Although it is a supply of goods, but consideration? There is no consideration. Answer, but without consideration also it becomes supply. But that is in 71C. 71C. Not in 71. A and in 71C we did not have any replacement, free warranty replacement kind of thing, so it's not a supply because it is without consideration. I told you, no, 71C you cannot stretch beyond its purpose.
Yes.
71C you have to apply as it is. Okay, this activity is without consideration, only that is taxable, deemed supply. Balance, any other activity done without consideration cannot be considered as supply. Okay, replacement business customer without consideration, so GST is not chargeable. Penalties levied on delayed. Huh, now this is very important point, and anyhow it will come in valuation again. But this is the important point. Example 29. What happened is this, and this is the real case. Okay. There is a client that I'm like auditor of that particular client, and then client have franchisee business. You understand franchisee business? They run on franchisee model, so they are having more than 300-400 franchises all over India. Now you are franchisee owners. So whatever business you people do in that month, some percentage of your business you have to give it as a franchisee rent to owners. Okay. So giving franchisee, is it a business?
Yes.
Yes, so it is taxable in law, not problem. So your consideration per month is almost 1 lakh rupees. Okay, everyone has to pay 1 lakh rupees. Our franchisee agreement says if you don't pay within 1 month, hello, we are going to put minimum 15% interest per annum on you. Hello. So this company asked me this question. There are lot of these franchise dealers who don't pay us on time, and then we are taking interest from them. 8,000, 2,000, 5,000 additional. So they will pay 1 lakh rupees consideration and 5,000 additional as the interest for delayed consideration. Because you are not paying consideration on time. We have given you 30 days period, but in 30 days you are not paying us. So after that we will start charging interest. Yes or no? Alright, so here also, in institution also, if we, are, we said your fees is 40,000, but you have to pay in this installment, if you don't pay, we will take 500 rupees extra. Hello? Alright, so there is no question about whether that 1 lakh rupees is chargeable to GST or not, that everybody knows 1 lakh rupees is chargeable to GST. They were arguing with me that 5,000 rupees extra interest that we have charged is not chargeable to GST because it is not there in invoice. Original invoice which was issued was only for 1 lakh and our service value is only 1 lakh. You did not pay me on time, therefore I am charging interest 5,000. So that 5,000 should not be taxable. This is what the company was saying. I said, you don't understand, sir. You are tolerating their non-performance. You understand? Tolerate karna means seh lena. You are tolerating their non-performance, and tolerance of non-performance or tolerance itself is a service.
Yes.
Tolerance itself is a service. If I am suffering because of you, I am ready with it, and for that I am charging 5,000 rupees, then I am providing you services of tolerance.
Yes.
I am tolerating your non-performance, and that 5,000 is also taxable. That 5,000 is also taxable as a service, and it is clearly written in valuation rule. You will understand it gradually. Clearly it is written, any consideration for a delayed in consideration, any consideration for a delayed in consideration is also a part of value, and therefore it is taxable. Hello? Alright? So what is written here? Penalties levied on late or delayed payment of loan and advances is taxable supply. So answer is yes, these are taxable supply. Here they have not given any explanation. Explanation you will get from section 15, valuation. Okay? Can I go ahead? Now this is the question on 7.1b. What was the 7.1b? 7.1a is done. Almost 29 questions they have given only on one clause. How can you forget 7.1a then? You understand? Almost 29 questions we have discussed till now, which was on 7.1a. Obviously it is important, therefore your institute is trying to put different situations for you. All the situations that we had covered till now, we were belonging to 7.1a. Now 7.1b, do you remember 7.1b?
Yes.
Importation of service for a consideration, whether or not in the course of business. So let's see some examples of it. Suppose supply of service for rupees 1 crore was initiated prior to introduction of GST. So discussion had happened before GST. Before GST means before 1st July. Before 1st July, a payment of 20 lakhs has already been made to supplier, and service tax also has been paid on the same. So on that time, before GST, there was a service tax. Out of 1 crore, 20 lakh was paid as an advance, and on 20 lakh service tax was also paid. Okay, that means now how much consideration you will receive after GST? 80. On 80 you have to charge GST, not a service tax. This was the question many people asked in 2017. Half contract, like I'm teaching you now. I started teaching you. This is a 2017 year, and before this, hello, are you getting this? Before this, you have paid half of the fee. Say for example, your fees is 50,000. 20,000 you have paid before GST, and then government brought GST. Syllabus is still going on. And now 30,000 you are going to pay me in advance, additional 30,000. So you are asking, on this 30,000 should I pay service tax or should I pay GST? So government gave clear cut notification that time itself. Now whatever is balance payment, hello, on all that balance payments you must pay GST, not old law. Old laws are deleted. Okay, so that's clarification they have given here. So then IGST have to be paid on 80 lakh. On balance, IGST have to be paid. Next, can I go ahead?
Yes.
Online information and database access or retrieval services were import of free services from Google, Facebook by Gopal. Do you pay any GST on Google and Facebook?
No.
Because you are using that for free. There is no consideration. Will it be covered by 7.1a?
No.
Why? Because 7.1a on two, business and consideration. Can it be covered by 7.1b? No, why? Because 7.1b, import of service for a consideration. Is it a consideration? No. Can it be covered by 7.1c without consideration? No. Why? Because the very basic reason, Google and Facebook is not your related party.
Yes.
Hello, 7.1c is only applicable to
related party.
Import of service without consideration in the course of business from a related party. Hello, Google mama hai kya tumhara? Right. So Google and Facebook is not. So is it a supply or not a supply?
Not a supply.
You can write two reasons. It is not in the course of business, and it there is no consideration. Okay, therefore it is not a supply. Service GST is levyable only when it is supplied for a consideration. Import, okay. Import, downloading. You are downloading song. You know, in iPhone we cannot download songs.
Yes.
We have to download only from iTunes.
Mm.
And iTunes charges money.
Yes,
yes or no?
Yes.
All right. So are they charging money? Is there consideration? Do we have consideration? You are downloading some videos or some movies or some softwares by paying money. By paying money, consideration is there.
Yes.
Do we have consideration? But it is not in the course of business. Movie and all is not in the course of business, right? So is it taxable or not taxable? Is it a supply or not a supply? Business is not there, consideration is there. Supply, but not in 71A. 71B. Why? Because, sir, it is a supply and IGST. Why IGST? Because it is deemed to be interstate. Import, no, import of service,
yes.
Deemed to be interstate. It's not intrastate, no,
yes.
Import of service. Under which section? Under section 71B. Under section 71B. And what is the logic? Service may be in the course or furtherance of business or not. Business is there or not, it is not important in 71B. Yes or no?
Yes.
Can I go ahead?
Yes.
So this is 71B case law. Mr. C of Chennai paid fees for online coaching. Yeah, online coaching is also available. Lot of
yes.
Foreign courses you can do online. Online coaching obtained from a teacher located in USA for coaching of accountancy course to his son. So son is getting this lecture. Yes or no? Consideration is there or not there?
Yes.
But it is personal service.
Yes.
It's okay, 71B. It is taxable under section 71B. But then they are writing, yes, it is a supply, even if the recipient of service is not a business. Hello, this is not in the course of
business.
Mr. C is not liable to pay GST under reverse charge mechanism. Why? Because it is exempt under GST. It is education service, no? Online database and writ. So that is separate thing. But is it a supply?
Yes.
Right now we are discussing, because you don't know exemptions. So right now you should understand only whether it is a supply or not a supply. Education is exempted, no? So that is, the exemption is separate. Right now we need to understand whether it is supply or not a supply. Supply under section 71B. Next. Micro apparels in Chennai. Apparels means you understand, no? Cloth and all. Apparels means cloth, okay? Micro apparels in Chennai, Tamil Nadu, avails fashion design services 50 lakh from a Prabhu Designs in Singapore. So what is happening here? Prabhu Designing Singapore is import of service, no?
Yes.
And they are bringing this service in the course of business for a consideration.
Yes.
Which clause is applicable?
Yes.
71A. It is the import of service. Who will pay tax? That fashion designer from Singapore or Tamil Nadu company?
Tamil Nadu
company. Why? Because there is RCM. No, we have discussed that yesterday. Import of service is taxable under RCM. Yes or no? Reverse charge mechanism. Are you getting this? Can I continue like this? Yes or no? Alright. Import of some services by Indian branch from their parent company in the course of furtherance of business without consideration. So parent company. My parent company is outside. Parent company means holding company. Related parties? Yes or no? Without consideration?
Yes.
Still it is supply. Why? Because it is covered under 71C. It is there. Import of service from a related party. It is supply. Alright. Yes, it is taxable supply in India. In IGST will be levied under reverse charge basis. Indian entity will pay tax. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Next. We will pause it here and then I will take your queries.